Wordle. What's the best starting word? It's not a do. AROSE runs circles. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. As a follow-up to my video about the Wordle helper that I built in Excel, the question is, what is the best Wordle starting word? And there's lots of articles about this. A lot of people like a do because it gets rid of a lot of vowels. This great tweet here, on the day that the Wordle answer is a do, social media will implode. I don't think a do is a great word. These are the words that I found online, and a lot of them seem to be using the Wheel of Fortune strategy. You know, at the end of a Wheel of Fortune, they give you R-S-T-L-N-N-E, so looking for words that have a lot of those. Rather than the Wheel of Fortune strategy, let's take a statistical look at this. In column A, I have the 8,000 plus Scrabble words that are five letters. Use some Excel functions here, which I'll explain in the outtake, to break that out to figure out how many words have the letter A or B or C. We end up with this pivot table over here, and the top five most popular letters are S, E, A, R, and O. So a word that has those five letters is going to win. I think the best word is AROSE. It has all five target letters. If you're looking at the top six letters, which includes then the letter I, you also get ARISE and OSIER. If you think about it, RAISE, SURREY, those are just basically anagrams of ARISE. So I think we throw those out. Amongst the items here, I came up with how many of the target letters does it have, but then also this one. For the score over here, I'm adding up the count of letters for each of the five letters. The theory being that if we guess an S and get a gray tile, then we eliminate 4124. That's more value to me than eliminating, let's say, 924 if we find out there's not a K, or 79 words if there's not a Q. Comparing my word, AROSE, or these backup words here, I mean, if you think about it, if we all started using AROSE every day, the Wordle people would take advantage of that. So it's nice once in a while to throw in ARISE just for a little variability. But let's compare these scores to the words that I find online all the time. I've used some of these, stare or store or ado or audio. You know, the problem with ado and audio is the U, right? Throwing the U out. The U is used in relatively so few of 1657 compared to the O or the I. It really scores very poorly. So while ado used to be my go-to starting word, from now on it's going to be AROSE. Give that a try on your next Wordle. If you want to see some of the geeky Excel behind this, stick around for the outtakes. Otherwise, let's wrap up. If you like these videos, please down below, like, subscribe, and ring the bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the comments below. As Nancy plays us out, don't forget to hang around if you want to see some of the Excel deep dive behind this. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel. All right, hey, let's check out some of this, this cool Excel here. To break a five-letter word into five individual letters using the MID function, but asking for the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, which gets me A-A-H-E-D. But then this cool second argument to the unique, saying that it's by column. That's the first time I think I've ever used by column. And that gets rid of the duplicate extra A in there and gets me A-H-E-D like that. The VSTACK, this is a Charles Williams function. And then to get rid of the zeros that are being returned by that, just a simple little filter function there. Give me everything from H2 hash, where H2 hash is not equal to zero. Straight pivot table here. I'm actually wondering if I should have just done this with a couple of array functions. All right, then you put in how many letters you're looking for. Cool little function here. The index asking for the sequence of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, which gets me S-E-A-R-O-I. And then this one is one that I was really, really happy with, this little formula over here. Let me break that one down for you. All right, so what I did is I said, start off by saying, I want to figure out, you know, how many of my target letters, S-E-A-R-O-I, are in AROSE. So I asked for the equal find, and what am I trying to find? I'm going to try and find all six of those letters, so that O-5 hash. Putting in the hash, I still need to press F4. To lock that down. And where are we looking? We're looking in the word AROSE, right? And so for each of the six letters we're looking for, we're going to get where it's found. So the S is found in the fourth position, the E is found in the fifth position, and so on. But the I down here is not found at all, right? So in this case, it's returning an array of six. I would ask for the top seven letters, I'm getting an array of seven. You see how that works, right? To simplify it down to just a single value, I wrap that in the count function. The count function will throw out the value errors and give me just the ones that hit. I was really happy with that. Okay, and this big formula here, right, it's working from the inside, asking for the mid of arose, and I pass the sequence of 1 through 5. Of course, sequence 1 through 5 gives me the five letters. So that forces mid to give me AROSE, which we'll see right here, AROSE. And in case there's any duplicates there, I get rid of them. That way, if there were two S's, it doesn't count twice. And so then I have those five letters, AROSE, and I do an XLOOKUP of each of those letters into this table, looking for the letter and then the count of letters, and finally sending the whole thing back into the sum function to sum up the score. Cool little function there. So all kinds of great dynamic array formulas being used throughout this.